Good morning, children. Welcome to the online classroom of 12th Commerce English Medium for the subject Organization of Commerce and Management, that is OC. We have in the last week studied chapter number 1, which talked about the introduction to the meaning of management, different functions of management, what is the importance of management, characteristics of management, and different functional areas where management can be applied in an organization. We have also studied that management is said to be science because it has some rules, some systematized manner, systematic principles that are applied. We have also studied management as an art as well. Children, this chapter is talking about the principles of management. So, what is the meaning of principles? Principles means some kind of rules or statements that are framed through various experiences of the past and accepted as a general guideline or a statement that can be applied to each and every situation of the management. So, principles of management. Is chapter mein hum kya padhne wale hain? Ki in any field, wherever we have to perform the managerial functions, that is planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, yeah, management ke related कोई भी एक्टिविटी अगर आपको करनी है राइट तो उसके कुछ प्रिंसिपल्स हैं विच कैन बी अप्लाइड सो दैट हम मैनेजमेंट फंक्शन को और इजीली कर सके वी कैन डू इट स्मूथली तो फ्यू सच प्रिंसिपल्स विच आर ऑलरेडी फ्रेम्ड बाय द मैनेजमेंट एक्सपर्ट्स वो हम इस चैप्टर में स्टडी करने वाले हैं See, keep one thing in mind, children, that whatever principles of management that are stated does not necessarily apply to all the situations and all the activities. But yes, if we accept them as a guideline, if we take them as an help, it can definitely make our task smoother. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the introduction and meaning of principles of management, concept of principle of management, nature and importance of management. Yes, management, as we all know, is an activity that is carried out since olden times. If we look at history, we will come to know about various rulers or various dynasties where management played the very important role, like during the rule of Chandragupta Maurya, Chhatrapati Shivaji. We can see the use of management where in the policy of war and war strategies. Various management gurus, thinkers, ideologies and authors have time to time rendered new principles and new guidelines through various experiences. From last many years, the ideology of management has been presented through different forms of approaches. Various management gurus in the West like Frederick Taylor, Henry Fayol, Gilbreth, Max Weber, Chester Bernard, Peter Drucker and C.K. Prahlad have played the important role in providing the various principles. Harold Kuntz has also said that management is a jungle. Let us have the meaning of what is principle of management. Principles of management plays the role of a guide for the managers. Right? Yes. Why they are said to be guide? Because they don't provide the exact solution for how the thing is to be done, but it definitely guides or provide the different ways through which management can be made easy. In fact, principles of the management are not the rules. They are only the sum and substance of the assumptions, tradition and experiences. Kuch assumption kar lete hain. If the situation of strike is there, then how to deal with it. If any natural calamities occur, to us time bhi labors ko kaise work provide karna hai. What are the different techniques through which लेबर टर्नओवर को कम कर सके एक्सेट्रा. इसके लिए डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंसेस, कुछ एजम्पशन, ये सारी चीज़ें प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट में बताई गई है. डिफरेंट मैनेजमेंट गुरुज हैव कम टू द कंक्लूजन इन डिफरेंट सिचुएशन एंड हैव प्रूव देम इन द प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ. इन द बिजनेस यूनिट रूल्स प्रिंसिपल माइट बी फॉर्म्ड इन रिलेशन टू ह्यूमन बिहेवियर. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर सोल प्रोप्रेटरशिप बिजनेस है जिसमें 3-4 वर्कर्स ही उसके साथ काम करते हैं, तो फॉर्म ऑफ मैनेजमेंट विल बी डिफरेंट. फॉर्म ऑफ मैनेजमेंट मीन्स डिफरेंट टास्क, क्योंकि अगर छोटा सा बिजनेस है तो उसमें एक अकाउंटिंग डिपार्टमेंट बनाना, एक HR डिपार्टमेंट बनाना, एक प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट बनाना, इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल. सो इन सच केसेस 3-4 डिफरेंट वर्कर्स कैन बी वर्किंग अंडर वन सिंगल मैनेजमेंट हु इज at top, bottom as well as middle level management and assigning directly work to the workers. On the other hand, agar koi bada business organization hai in which there are thousands of people working in one single organization, that is, it is a big or large organization, to wahan pe pura organization structure hoga. Depending on the type of employees, there can be different management ideas. Like बहुत बड़ा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हो तो देर विल बी वन HR डिपार्टमेंट जो रिक्रूटमेंट और सिलेक्शन के साथ काम करता है, वन मार्केटिंग डिपार्टमेंट जो सेलिंग इंक्रीज करने का काम करता है. एंड सेम वे, से फॉर एग्जांपल देयर आर 100, 150 और 500 पर्सन वर्किंग ओनली फॉर द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ क्लोथ और सेट ऑफ वेयर. वी आर हैविंग द वेरी गुड एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस विल्सबन, वेयर नॉट ऑल द एम्प्लॉयज आर ऑफ say graduation or post graduation level, but they are simply workers. Most women are employed, so in such case different management techniques are also applied, and these principles of management only makes the organization work successfully. Now let us look at the concept. Management is a combination of art and science. As a science, it is natural that it will be having principles, rules. Principles of management are not rigid as pure science, but yes, they are flexible. That means, as per the changing situation, we can modify these rules. But management is definitely having the direct relation with the human behavior. Thus, by making required changes, there is a scope of additional new principles. Human behavior and technology are such factor which changes from time to time. If we talk about say olden days, some 10-20 years ago, ठीक है, तो उस वक्त industries कैसे थे? It was limited only to particular field, particular type of person. So management was different. Like whatever order was passed by the management person had to be strictly followed. Now with increase in the employment opportunity, with increase in the population, we are having more persons seeking for the job and less employment opportunities. And in such situation, to select the best employee, to maintain them in the organization, most important part that plays role is job satisfaction of the employee, personal development of the employee. So as a part of management, all these things also take place. Using these principles, different other activities are carried out. Principles of management are detailed and perfect guideline for decision making and its implementation. As per the principle of management, the capability of employee could be increased through various encouragement, like to consider his service for years, टू गो फॉर द प्रमोशन, टू गो फॉर द ट्रांसफर और टू गिव देम एडेड फाइनेंशियल बेनिफिट्स, टू गिव द सोशल सिक्योरिटी एंड सो ऑन. सो वॉट आई बेसिकली मीन टू से दैट सच डिसीशंस कैन बी टेकन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वेरियस प्रिंसिपल्स. Now it is very important to understand the difference between principles of management and technique of management. Method or techniques are set up of steps that are taken to achieve the target, while the principles are the guidelines for the decisions which have been taken during the implementation of techniques. For example, let us talk about a human behavior or social security of the employee, right? In such situation, if a person or an employee is say working for 10 years in the organization, right? तो वो मैनेजमेंट के लिए एक एसेट हो जाता है कि द पर्सन इज सीनियर इनफ नोइंग ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. अब उसको जॉब सिक्योरिटी देने का एक ऑप्शन अगर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के मन में आता है तो दैट इज वन ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल्स विच वी आर अप्लाइंग, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल और गिविंग देम जॉब सेटिस्फेक्शन एंड और सोशल सिक्योरिटी. तो फॉर दैट इफ एनी सच स्टेप इज टेकन लाइक टू गिव प्रमोशन, टू गिव ट्रांसफर टू हिज hometown or to give the added bonus or salaries is a different technique that is used for this principle implementation. So methods or technique means the step that are taken to achieve the target, and principles are the guidelines for the decisions which have been taken during the implementation of the techniques. Like the target may be of production of say 10,000 units or more 10,000 units. For that, the steps that are taken to make it successful can be increasing the manpower, it can be increasing the working hours of the men. So these are the different techniques through which management can be done. It is needful to understand the difference between principles and values like techniques. Values are acceptable, it relates with morality, while the principles are universal. That means it can be applied to each and every situation. Now let us look at the nature of principles of management. Principles of management kaise hote hain, uske characteristics. See, principle of management does not mean it is having one particular restricted definition. Principles of management simply means management के ऐसे rules, ऐसे regulations जिनको हम अपनी day to day life में use करके management को और smooth बना सकते हैं. If we talk about organizational structure, तो principles of management वो डिफरेंट प्रिंसिपल्स है, वो नए रूल्स है जो बहुत सारे मैनेजमेंट गुरुज ने हमारे लिए बनाए कि हम उनको डायरेक्ट यूज करके वी कैन टेक द बेस्ट डिसीजन. प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट आर नॉट रिजिड बट आर हैविंग द प्रैक्टिकल कंक्लूजन. दीज प्रिंसिपल्स आर गाइडलाइंस एट द टाइम ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ डिफरेंट टास्क लाइक प्लानिंग करना, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, प्रोवाइडिंग डायरेक्शन, प्रोवाइडिंग गाइडेंस टू द एम्प्लॉय, इट प्रोवाइड गाइडलाइंस टू द मैनेजर टू टेक द अप्रोप्रिएट डिसीजन. एज पर द एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन मोस्टली दीज प्रिंसिपल्स आर ट्रूथ बट दे आर नॉट द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ. ट्रूथ मीन्स इट इज एक्सेप्टेड एवरीवेयर, वेर एज एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ truth means it can be modified, but absolute truth means no matter what the situation we have to accept as a fact. So principle of management are truth, that means it provide guidelines and can be modified as and when required. Now what are the nature? First one is universal acceptance. That is principles of management, all these rules can be applied to most of the business units where there is involvement of human, where more than two persons आर वर्किंग टुगेदर टू अचीव द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑब्जेक्टिव और से इन आर डे टू डे लाइफ. हाउएवर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ ऑल द प्रिंसिपल में चेंज एज पर टाइप, कौन से टाइप का बिजनेस है, वॉट इज द साइज ऑफ बिजनेस, द डिफरेंट एक्टिविटीज कैरिड आउट इन द बिजनेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ अ कंपनी इज इन्वॉल्व ओनली इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ मार्केटिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट गुड्स और डिफरेंट कंपनीज, तो दे आर नॉट कंसर्न विद द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. सेम वे इफ द कंपनी इज डीलिंग ओनली विद द प्रोडक्शन और ओनली विद से मैनेजमेंट, तो दे आर हैविंग सम डिफरेंट रोल्स. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स आर फ्लेक्सिबल, दैट मीन्स दे डू नॉट डिराइव टू एनी रिजिड कंक्लूजन, बट एज पर द सिचुएशन मैनेजर को जहाँ पे रखे, दे आर हैविंग फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी टू चेंज इट. When this principle do not seem to match in the situation, manager is allowed to effect the change. For example, division of work may be applied uniformly in large unit, but when we talk about small business units, so division of work cannot be applied in same proportion. Like if you are talking about big organization, then division of work can be done according to the skill of the employee. But if the organization is small, the division of work is done as per the requirement of the organization. General guideline. This principles of management provides the general guidelines and statement based on the various experiences gained by the different experts. At the time of managing business unit, complex problems arise. The form of these issues are different every time, but which could not give similar result for each business unit or all the situations. So, principle of management cannot be strictly applied, but it can give you the desired result. Based on human behavior. As we know that human is the center of every activity in the organization, or all the managerial activities are done by human, so human becomes the, so the principles of management are based on human behavior. They have direct relationship between the human behavior. As the human behavior is a psychological phenomenon, it is necessary to consider while implementing principles of management. For to understand this, let us take the example of different needs of different individual of the organization. Not every employee is working only to get the salary. There are different satisfaction levels for different employees. So, to motivate the employees, depending on individual, we can motivate the person. See, if a person is working for earning to run the house, then in such situation, financial motivation plays the important role. If the person is, say, working for the hobby or having keen interest on personal development, then he can be motivated in that way to work for the organization. So that is why it is said that it is based on human behavior. Contingency, it is the element that to apply the principles of management. Achievement of the goals can be made easier by a unit with taking required decision through usage of these principles in certain unavoidable situation, such as to pay appropriate and reasonable wages to the employees. This criteria of being fair and reasonable depends upon concern regarding necessity and contingency of the affecting factors. Let us look at the last topic of today's session, that is importance of these principles of management. अब आपको ये पता चल गया कि जो management के principles और rules है वो flexible है, आपकी situation के according हम उसको change कर सकते हैं, human behavior पे based हैं, they are accepted everywhere. That means they are important for managerial activity. अब उससे क्या क्या benefit हो सकते हैं, तो सबसे पहला है it increases the managerial efficiency. For example, let us take your as a student, let us take your example only. When you have to say perform a fun fair, you have to organize the fun fair. You are having few ideas that, okay, I will have 10 different stalls. I will go for the sponsorship. I will take 150 rupees as a charge from the stall person. And this is how I'm going to arrange the finance. But along with that, if one expert joins you, who guides you that different and provides you different solutions for more fundraising, right? The person joins you and help you how to perform the different activities. For example, managing the rush, managing the account at the time of fun fair. So all such thing increases your managerial efficiency as they provide you guidelines to manage the task. Maximum usage and effective administration of resources can be done. Human and physical resources are limited for every business. It is unavoidable to make its maximum usage. We need to make the optimum and maximum utilization of these resources. In other words, no wastage should be done. Wastage of manpower in the form of man working hours, wastage of natural resources should be avoided, or complete utilization should be done. So, uske liye bhi hame proper administration ke liye we are these principles provide us the guideline helpful for scientific as well as logical decision making. Decision are always needed to be taken in managerial activity, like manpower ko employ karna, production ko start karna, selling kab karna hai, marketing kaise karni hai, different types of decisions are required to be taken. In such situation, this decision are always taken based on the fact and different objectives. Decision should be taken timely based on reality and they should be effective. Management principle provide a key role for taking the appropriate decisions. To cope up with the changing business environment, political changes aana, business environment mein changes aana hai, naye social structure mein change aana, to meet all these changes, these principle guidelines help the management to fulfill the social responsibility. No business is running only for the purpose of making profit. Each and every business organizations are having their duty towards society. They are having the social responsibility as well, as they are the part of community. Development, progress of society is also the aim of the business unit. By effective implementation of management principles, business unit can easily achieve aim of the social responsibility. It is also useful for the research, for training, as well as development of an manager. Management principles are the part of management. By using this principle, task of training, education, development is possible. Like, we have aptitude test taken by various units to check out the aptitude or the skill of management in the different employees before these employees are appointed. Let us have a quick look that we have learnt today. Today we have seen the meaning of principles of management. The principles of management have been working since the time of Chandragupta Maurya and Chhatrapati Shivaji. Right, we have also seen the video of Chanakya, right, in our last academic year, which also discussed about how the entire government is running, the structure that was formed from central government to state government and then panchayats, so that proper smooth functioning at each and every level can be made in the country. We have also studied about the difference between principles and techniques of management. We have seen the nature of principle of management, that is, they are universally accepted, flexible, provide the guidelines and based on human behavior. These principles of management are important because they increase the management efficiency. They also result in the maximum usage and effective administration of resources. They fulfill the social responsibilities also. In our next session, we will be discussing the thoughts of management, that is neoclassical, classical and modern management, scientific management and 14 principles given by Henry Fayol. Bye-bye. Take care. Bolo. Shh.